name of the game. And nice guys get washed away like the snow and the rain. There's been a load of compromising on the road to my horizon, but I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me. Like a
Willie Stroker's on line one.
And offers coming over the phone.
Now tonight we're gonna take your calls. We're
special
take,
live appearance.
We're gonna take your calls, but if we feel the demeanor of your call is not appropriate, we're gonna cut you off. That's the way it is.
The way of the world.
We're not gonna take, if you don't like me, hey, great, God bless you. But if you have a demeanor tonight with me, we're gonna cut you right off. That's the way it is.
Jesus was who he was. He was the man. That's true.
Hallelujah!
There were thousands of disciples.
Hallelujah!
But anyways, put your hands back on the screen. Put your hands back on the screen.
Yeah, I'm gonna sit here and fight in your face, and you'll like it. I'll fight and blow smoke in your face, and you'll love it. I sit here from thousands and thousands of years, and people come from everywhere just to hear and smell my fight. You know why? Because my fight will make you smell better. Yes, I'm sitting here right now on this stool, and I'm ready to have a stool. But my stools are just fine. People will come from Jamaica, man. People will come from Africa. People will come from London. They will come everywhere just to smell my fart. Because my fart, my friend, will make you smell better. And you'll love it, and you'll like it. I'll blow smoke out of my mouth, and you know what? You'll like it. I will take my armpit like this and go like this. You know what? You'll love it too. I will blow smoke out of my ass and I'll blow smoke out of my mouth and you'll like it. You'll love it. People come from miles and miles away from London and Asia and Europe and everywhere and they smell my aroma. My aroma will come and bless you. Yes, it will, because I fought. And I make you smell better, whether you like it or not. My fart will overwhelm you. Yes, it will.
This Richmond does really suck, and I'm here to tell you that it sucks. I always tell you that it sucks anytime you do see me on camera. I tell you that Richmond sucks, because that's all I really have to say about Richmond.
I mean, I can't tell you what, are you ready to get on the show here?
Yeah.
I gotta tell you what, it's gonna be a crazy thing. Anyway, let's get busy.
What in the hell is causing this? All of this. I'll tell you what's causing all of this. Me, on your TV screen, blessing you, full force. And you're loving it. Because ladies, I can see what you're doing right now. I can see you undressing right now in your living room. Because you know why? Woo! I said so, that's why. We got Mickey Mouse in here. How you doing, man? You alright? Alright. And we've got PR people in the back helping things out. Hey, we're kicking it to you live from RIC VA. It is known as Woo! The Gorgeous George Show. I am just styling and profiling as looking as old as I can look, like I always do. You already know that, so I don't have to really come out and say that because I am that daddy. Baby, I am what's causing all this. Woo! Because you need a 2x4 across your skull because you need to know about the Italian boy. You know about the pasta and the fettuccine that I cook? I think you should. Ladies out there, you know what I'll do? I'll cook you linguine carbonara. I'll cook you fettuccine alfredo, baby. And I will sing you a rhapsodized lullaby. Woo! And you can tell me what's causing all this. Baby, I am what's causing all this. And you rednecks, you don't like me? Hey, you can kiss my ass because I am what's causing all this. I am flamboyant, I am charismatic, and baby, it's time for a wake-up call. And you know, I tell you what, the dead weight is gone. The dead weight has evaporated. You know what I'm talking about? I think you do. Magic Matt, you buck-tooth varmint, you're history, buddy. You know, you're bye-bye. You're dead weight. You just sit there on the camera and look like a fat sack of potatoes, like you are. We got new key players, we got a lot to do in the show here, a lot of skits. Hey baby, I am what's causing all of this. Richmond knows about me. If you've been seeing me all along, blessing your screen, popping woo, through your underwear, ladies, you know what I'm talking about? Yes, I think you do. I am what's causing all this. Ladies and gentlemen, get used to it, because I am like a rash. Woo, you feel kind of hot, Mickey? Woo, you feel kind of, woo, get it? Don't you, Mickey? Yes?
Yeah.
Put your hand on the screen. Yes! Woo! I am what's causing all this. And listen a minute, you're going to find out why. Because we are RICVA. The Gorgeous George Show, that is what's causing this array of comical events. Coming to you, full force.
I can't get it.
So now, George, tell us, are you homosexual or bisexual?
Whatever one people want me to be, I be.
You be?
Yeah.
What really possessed you to really go out there and start doing what you're doing as far as
doing drag? I've been doing drag for a long time, ever since I was 13 years old. Nixon one time.
Did you really?
Yeah, he was.
He was a crook too.
Yeah. He was good to me. We had a gay meeting in Washington.
Do you all have like a little powwow? So now tell me, are you pregnant right now? Have a baby?
No, I wish I was. I'd be a rich bitch.
You'd be a rich bitch.
That's what you want.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's like that.
Okay.
You were into kissing babies on the head and maybe making babies too, because everybody sees it. You could make you have a baby right now.
Oh yeah, I wish I was.
You wish you were? Okay. Are you bisexual?
Anybody want me to be bisexual or homosexual or whatever?
Okay.
Tell him how you got the name Dirt Woman, Donnie.
Hey, I got the name Dirt Woman.
Well, of course, we all want to know.
Back in 76, I got arrested.
For
prostitution.
Another time when the man was trying to hold you down.
And the police, when the vice pulled me up in the back of the seat of the police car, and I shit all over the back of the police car. I picked the shit off the seat.
I
throwed it.
Public access.
I throwed it at the policeman.
How big are your stools?
Richmond is a fucked up city.
Oh, okay.
That was a homosexual.
Yeah. You see that now, but you are homosexual now.
Oh yeah, I'm a homosexual. I ain't gonna let nobody push open me and run off my life.
I'm sure Magic Matt would like to, all Magic Matt is old.
You know who I like?
Well, but you see, ladies out there know the deal and know the squeal. They know that I come in the middle of the night, just like Santa Claus sometimes, but every single night, you know the deal. I come to your house, ladies, and I kind of tell you another covers. You know, you kind of have bad dreams that you're looking at. The gorgeous George takes care of you, ladies. What he does, he gives you that deep tissue massage. Rubs your calves, and he rubs your buttocks. Make sure your buttocks is so smooth, and he goes up to your chest and rubs that too. Tell you what, ladies out there, you want to cool off. Woo! You want to be woo! Chill! Gorgeous George, chill. And you can still kiss this lady. Because I am the Mac Daddy, baby, and I am what's causing all this. Now,
what about my kiss, honey?
I don't. How about this?
That was a pretty
bitch. He's being well paid tonight for his services here tonight, and of course I'm sure that he'll be more glad to do any kind of services for you ladies and gentlemen, any other kind of creature out there that wants to serve.
Hey there, sexy, why don't you come over here and shake that jam with me? Right on!
Router. Does he have any tits or what? What do you think? No, I don't think I want to know. Come on. Now, go ahead and let one out right now.
Live from Gold's Gym, the Gorgeous George Show. Y'all get ready to do some watching this, some sweat, some iron pumping, some steel pushing, some big muscle building, bonding up, kind of, man, you just ain't seen nothing like it. So come on with it and let's get down with George.
You got it. It's working cool.
Got it on me.
Oh, yeah.
She loves me. I love myself. She loves me. I love myself. Ladies and gentlemen, we're just cranking it here for you in Gold's Gym. Got a little sore today, but it's quite all right. She loves me. I love myself. Ladies and gentlemen, we're at Gold's Gym here. In a little bit, we're going to let you talk to one of the GMs here at Gold's Gym. He's going to tell you all about it. Hang tight.
Sorry.
Ladies and gentlemen, you too can have the pleasure of working out here at Gold's Gym. I work out at Gold's Gym. And we tell you what, we are really pumped for the occasion. I'm pumped in every angle. Ladies out there, you know the deal, you know the squeal. It's Gorgeous George, and we are what's causing this. I'm getting off to it right now. It's called working your body.
What do you say when you feel a burn, George?
I say, woo!
Nah, I knew it.
I say, woo! Don't do this enough, ladies and gentlemen. Don't do this enough.
One more because you're gorgeous.
Ah, one more because I said so.
One more because you're gorgeous.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't do this enough, but watch the master. Woo!
The show has been a major, major success story. It's like I've got some letters that we read. We've kind of neglected the fans out there, all these letters here, and we don't really. We read that many on other shows until, I mean, we used to read a lot of letters, but now we've got letters to read, and I want to address the fans out there. I can't read all your letters, and I do appreciate you sending your letters in to the Gorgeous George Show. You know, it has to be stated right now, too, that there is a brand new fan club number. 254-2500 is the brand new Gorgeous George hotline. Yes, baby, it is the brand new spanking Gorgeous George hotline. And it's thousands and thousands of calls coming in daily. 254-2500. Give me a call sometime and tell me what you think. Hey, because we do a service to you out there. We service the community out there. A long day hard from work, you come home and you're just beat and exhausted. Don't watch Steinfeld. No. Don't watch the reruns of MASH. No. Don't watch old Family Feud or Wheel of Fortune or Jeopardy. No. Sit back and watch the Gorgeous George Show, alive and well. Our live show, my live shows, and my pre-recorded shows. The best entertainment value for you out there, guaranteed. Don't watch Steinfeld, okay? Don't watch MASH. Watch the Gorgeous George Show. We're getting some letters out here from the fans. I do appreciate all these letters we get and all these letters that I get. Let me go ahead and read this right here. Gorgeous George, I have to say that I watched your show on Continental Cable TV, and I know that you are very much original and unique in what you do. I just want to know, basically, when you plan to get more musical groups on your show. I've got a musical group, and I'd like to know if you're on your show. Well, that's something. You know, the next letter we got here. Gorgeous George, I want to ask you the whereabouts of Magic Matt. I know in the last couple of shows that Magic Matt has not been involved in what you do, and I'm just kind of curious to find out where is his whereabouts. Sincerely, Debbie. Well, let me just say this right now, so there's no questions asked about this. Magic Matt is no longer involved in what I do. Okay? You know, we had to kind of take out the dead weight, so to speak. Magic Matt was dead weight, and we gave him the exit door. That's all that matters about that. Let me go ahead and read another letter to you all. Because all these letters here, I tell you what, I just don't know which ones to read and which ones not to read. Let me read this one before I read the other one. Dear Gorgeous George, I want to know about the contest. You did an ongoing contest at the very beginning when you were doing your shows on Continental Cable TV about the women going out with you and Matt. And we want to know more about if you're continuing the contest for women to win a night on the town with you and Matt. Well, I have been putting that on hold, but I'm glad you out there, you viewer out there, addressed that because we have a brand new contest, believe it or not. The third place prize winner wins a night on wins a Gorgeous George t-shirt. That's right. It wins a beautiful, beautiful Gorgeous George t-shirt. Simply the best Gorgeous George, and we have those copies out, like mass copies. We give those things out to free to my fans. That's what it boils down to. And you ladies call me up and say you want a Gorgeous George t-shirt, and we'll give you one free. Second place prize winner wins a night on the town with Slick Scott. Of course, baby, what's causing all this? I am what's causing all this. Gorgeous George. You win a night on the town, Gorgeous George. Woo, baby. What else more can you ask for? You know what I'm saying? Woo, baby. A night on the town with Gorgeous George. Hey, you know? You win Captain George's seafood. I'll take you ladies out to lobster, and I'll spoon-feed you the spoon-fed bread. Hey, because I said so. That's what it boils down to. You know what I'm saying? We've been doing this for a year and a half. I've been doing this for a year and a half with different people helping me out, coming and going. When bands don't show up, when key players or when people that are interested, that are upset that they want to come on the show and don't show up, hey, we go ahead and we improvise. Improvisation, we improvise and we do a great deal of improvisation, and that's the way it works out. I don't blow my top, okay? I make the best at what I've got, and we take pride. I take pride. I've paid the price of blood, of lead, sweat, and paid the price to get the show on. Homegrown, Richmond's best. Richmond's homeboy on the verge of making it big. That's what, I kid you not. Right now, I am talking to Blab TV. We're talking to Fox 35, okay? I've talked to different people in other areas and different markets. They get their show syndicated. They get their show syndicated on mainstream TV. This is going to happen, and this is going to happen. It is the center of the mantelpiece. If you don't like what I do, hey, I'm not going to harp on that. Change the freaking channel, you trash. You trash out there, change the channel. Where is George, the man who's causing all this? Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
Once again, time for me to come on your TV screen and piss you off, whether you like it or don't like it. And Richmond, I've succeeded by pissing you off. You build a stable, you build a fart, a personality conflict. Yes, there is a personality conflict between me and Matt. But thinking about it, talking to my agents, talking to the people, they told me, George, you need Magic Matt back on the scene. You need to get Magic Matt back because he was the one that helped you start the show. You need to build the force back up, okay? And, you know, I thought about it long and hard, and I realized it was time to bring back in the Batman. Bring back in the man that's helped me carry the show the way it is. If you want to come over this side over here, because I'm better on this side. I better pose on this side. Matt!
Hey, what's up, gorgeous George? How you doing?
What's going on, man? Good to see you back here. Good to see you back on the show.
What's up?
And I have succeeded! Now, Matt, we got you back on. I'm giving you a second try. I'm going against my better judgment, but I want you to prove me wrong. And you know what? I am causing the mercury to go up in this room. Whoa! I am causing their excitement. I am what's happening in Richmond. Okay? Randolph-Macon, you punks of Randolph-Macon, if you don't like me, woo! Learn to live with it. Okay? Woo! If you don't like me, you punks of Randolph-Macon, don't watch me. I am what's causing this. I am causing the mayhem in this room to go back and forth. The vocal points upon me. Star Weekly did a write-up on me.
Almost 2 years of TV, man.
Let's I've accomplished what I want.
George, 2 years almost on the air.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Are you for real? Are you back in focus?
Yes, sir, I am, man.
Huh?
I'm back in the mix.
You're back in the mix?
Back in the mix.
Okay. Don't let me down, and don't make me regret this time. Because if you stand me up, you know, it backfires in your face. We got this person, and I want to address to this person right out of here. You are a dancer, okay? And you got this punk boyfriend of yours. He calls my answering service and say, if I call you again, you're going to, you know, let me tell you something, punk. I'll call her again, whether you like it or don't like it, and then I'll slap you across, slap the taste out of your mouth, and you know what? You all like it. We got Howard Stern on tonight. Let's give it up for Howard Stern. Howard Stern's gonna be on tonight. I've got this petition going out right now. We're getting people to sign it left and right. People are signing. People want Howard back on, and it's because of me, because I am going to get Howard back on this market come hell or high water. I am a vocal point in Richmond, okay? I make it to what it is. I work this town. People know and people listen to me. Whether you like me or don't like me, you keep it on the station. You're compelled to watch me, okay? You're sitting at home, okay? You're saying, honey, let's change the channel. But you know what? Your wife is saying, no. Ooh, he gives me goose pimples. He gives me such a rash. I can't change the channel. Oh, we'll think about changing the channel. Ooh. And that's what it boils down to. Your wife is watching me because, ooh, I impregnated her the other day. Hey, let me tell you something. I idolize Ric Flair. I'm not trying to be Ric Flair. I am my own person, okay? People are saying, you're trying to be the nature boy. I am not the nature boy. Ric Flair, I have total respect for Ric Flair. I am Gorgeous George. Why not put your hand on the screen?
George,
ladies.
I have a question.
Oh, put your hand on the screen. You see, I'm memorizing, I'm making you think twice. You're looking at me and I'm looking at you. Oh, yes. Sabrina, woo! Put your hand on the screen. Woo! I can see what you're doing right now. You just saw the Macarena.
Bullshit.
Bull. Yeah, well, BS. I caught myself there. That's all right. Your punks are ran off making. You got a problem with me. Okay? We'll clear the clock. Your punks are ran off making. Your rednecks. Your trashy rednecks don't like me. Piss on you. Piss on you thoroughly. You know what I'm talking about? In a moment, we've got more stuff coming up the show. The saga continues. The series continues.
I'm going.
Woo, baby, the series continues. You know what's causing all this? I am causing all this. And you know what? I don't care what anybody says. Cowboys, baby, are going to the Super Bowl. The people in Richmond did what they succeeded to do by doing that.
Challenger Bob Dole here going against Clinton. He wants to give a few views and whatnot.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Bob.
This is Bob Dole. And what Bob Dole wants, Bob Dole. Yeah. I'm running for president. And I think the economy needs a better job. Oh, I am ecstatic to be here tonight. It is a holocaust to get your taxes on. Because I'm an idiot anyway. And, my running mate, there's an alien there. I can't believe it.
No, it's
me. Look at that. It's an alien. Whoa. Because I hope. I must have got crazy glue on. Oh, very glad to be here on this debate. I might just do that. I might go to Disneyland, and I might, I've taken this country, and I've made it flourish. I'm the independent. Here's my running mate, the alien from Mars. Here's what I see when I'm on the can looking at my Playboy magazine. We stand on the platforms of domination. If I had a device that would impregnate the women, oh, you think I would use it? Because I would use it. But Henry is now impotent. Prices of gas, hell, I'll take a plunger in my behind. I'll put a plunger in my behind, and I'll gas up the whole world with the plunger in my behind. With the Secretary of State will be the fart man. A fart man will be the Secretary of State. Come a little closer.
Come a little closer, I tell you. Come closer to the fart man. Ooh, the fart man's going to let a big one out. Oh, yes, he is. Oh, just like that. Ooh, the fart man's come, yes he is. Yes he is. Ooh, the fart man's come, yes he is. Yes he is. When I fart, the buildings come down, the skyscrapers come down with a bouncing, plunging ball. I've seen so much. When Hillary, when I saw you at the Spot Dance Club, and I'm tired of talking bad about the best president of the United States.
Everyone come to Disneyland, where all the people come and see me. Mickey! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! I'm letting you all kids know that when you come to Mickey Mouse, you'll see the naked version of me! I'll take off your shirt. You little boys out there, I'll take off your shirt and undress you. I'm Mickey Mouse. And I will give you the best time. Come to Disneyland. Ooh, M-I-C-K-E-Y.
Some key players once again didn't show up. That's all right. Covers. We discard Fatso, because Fatso's clogging up the whole bed. We push Fatso aside off the bed. And we'll have the great pleasure, the great pleasure of introducing my idol, my mentor. You know who this is? Do you know who I'm introducing? Howard Stern. And Howard Stern, before he comes in here, he is going to give me the award, the public access. Public access, Committee Access Channel 38, about 3 weeks ago, gave an award to the best comedy show on cable access. And it's a little bit, my mentor, my idol, Howard Stern. Howard Stern is going to give me the trophy, right behind the cameraman. He's going to give me the trophy and the service. And right now, without any further ado, here's the boy, here's my man, Howie, baby!
How are you, George?
How you doing? How you doing, Howard?
Well, first I'm going to give you this award for being the best comedy actor on Continental Cable Access.
Well, Howard, I do my best, man. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Well, Richmond. and I work my tail off, and it's, you know, I'm getting a petition out there to these fans out there to know what's going on here. Well, Howard?
I got kicked off Richmond TV and I'm pissed.
Yes. And I'm pissed too!
But now I'm on the airwaves.
This man is back on the airwaves. And Gorgeous George is back on the airwaves too. To piss you people, piss you conservative people off, and to piss you hillbillies off. You know what I'm talking about?
This
whole world can't take a little bit of truth serum, if you will. I'm trying to work behind the eight ball. And Howard, who are you voting for president?
I think I'm gonna vote for myself, George. What the fuck? I mean, what the hell?
And I want you to get them ladies. On the day that I was born, baby, I slapped a dad across the face. I said, you son of a gun, you witness greatness. But I got my award, the Continental Cable Access Award, ladies and gentlemen. Cameraman, put a zoom in that little thing right there.
Kind of looks like an Oscar.
I tell you what, I deserve an award for the role that I play. Woo! I deserve an award for my appearance. Woo! And I am educating you all to let you know that you style it. Woo! And profiling as I am. When you're looking as gorgeous and beautiful as I am and causing the women to divorce their men and drop them like a hot cake, and the fatso's being crying over tears because this boy right here, the Italian boy, is causing this mayhem. This Magic Matt's back in town. Magic Matt is back in We've got you to go out now and talk to these ladies out there to start a new pageant, because we are going to start a new pageant. Mm-hmm. Now, I want to know what kind of response you've had now.
What kind
of response have you had from the ladies out
there? Overwhelming response.
Okay.
I mean, every county, you know, Petersburg, yeah. Hanover, Goochland, everywhere. They're just,
when are
their
we
calls
getting,
are flooding
people
in.
People want to know, man. People want to know, when are we getting this pageant back in focus here? Because we're trying to recruit these ladies.
I believe sometime before Thanksgiving.
Okay.
November show, you know, you can look for a nice pageant.
It's
a
nice
lot
pageant.
Of lovely ladies.
It's very possible. It's very possible. And when you've got the wit this guy's got, okay, this is the reason right here of the divorce rate in Richmond, Virginia.
That's right.
This is the reason right here of the divorce rate in Richmond, Virginia.
That's right.
People all of town are taking their underpants and mailing them to me in the mail. Woo! We plan to get more of these awards. I know for 2 years service, it's a wonder I haven't got this sooner than I did. I should probably
we'll
got
get
this,
more.
Probably got a year ago.
Yeah.
But this is the award that I got over all the other shows on cable access. All the other shows on Continental Cable and Blab, and soon be Blab. I am like a rash, baby. You can't get rid of me. I'll keep coming back. You think I'm gone? You never know when Gorgeous George You never know when Gorgeous George is coming to town, when Gorgeous George is taking over your picture tube and is on your screen, because I am promoting a service. I am creating mayhem to all. And the fact that my beautiful, gorgeous self and my face is back on this TV screen is all that matters. Okay? It's all that matters. I am the Italian Stallion. I am Adonis. And whether you like it or don't like it. If it wasn't for my fans, this would have not happened. And I want to thank you all for supporting me. You other people out there, kiss my ass, kiss my rear end. This award right here. And I have succeeded.
Richmond, Virginia, Gorgeous George!
for you right now. We are what's causing all this. Musical groups, we are what's causing all this. Tonight, the Masons are going to prove themselves right now. Woo, baby, let's
right,
kick it.
Go, fundamentalists!
Two thousand years later. Eventually.
Tell you what, crank two more! Woo-hoo! Crank two more! Woo! Crank two more, guys!
Two more,
let's do it! Before four, guys, let's do it!
6.5 hours later. Twelve seconds later.
Come on, the Masons! It's not me, but the Masons! Here we go. I tell you what, I'm gonna come in here and interview you all right here. Hey, John, grab the camcorder. Grab the camcorder, John.
That one goes out to all you militia peters out there.
I tell you what.
Woo-hoo! My eyes are watering right now because it was so damn good. I was as sweating as you all were.
Thank you, sir. It's George, my man.
That's right. It's gorgeous, though. Thank you very much.
Whatever, that monkey boy. Are you a monkey boy? You ain't a monkey boy.
Pure love rock and roll.
Pure love rock and roll?
That's right.
She wants chicks, George.
You like chicks?
That's right. Yeah. To get laid.
Well, we're going to give you a gorgeous George t-shirt before it's all over, okay?
Woo!
That's good.
In the godless society.
All
right. That's right.
Okay, I'll meet you. Sorry. We're gonna kick one more song with the Masons, and they're gonna do it right now. Woo!
What are we doing? 1, 2, 3, 4!
Three 28 a.m.
Right back on the Gorgeous George show.
Things like that. Wash his car if I have to. And I feel very lucky to be here.
I went to the West Coast. I went to the East Coast. People keep dropping out like flies. Ladies and gentlemen, 2 days ago was my birthday. I had all the women around me. This one woman stood me up. Rednecks out there and you feminist bitches out there. What I think.
That's right.
Okay.
That's
what
right.
I think. You think. I am crazy. Yes, I'm crazy. You think that I don't know what I'm doing. Little do you know, whoa, ladies, I'm popping through your underwear. And I know what you're doing because I got x-ray vision. I can see you on the screen. Whoa! I am going to put things tonight in perspective. Oh, Gorgeous George, what do you have that pageant on? You had that freaking pageant on your TV screen. And you and these girls were no more than 17, 18 years old.
They were the Gorgeous George rejects, is what they were.
God.
The ones that did not make the first cut.
And you know what? And they tell me that, yes, you know, that these girls, you could have got caught for child pornography. Let me tell you something out there. These were ladies that were in 18, 19. They were legal. It's just a bunch of ridicule for no reason.
Then you gotta have a hobby. You have to have
then,
a hobby.
Then we
Gorgeous
have,
George's hobby is women.
That's
he
right.
can't help it.
Being ridiculed for, you know, for a pageant, okay? Being ridiculed for every show that I do, the conservatism in this town, hey, you need to wake up and smell the coffee. I have paid the dues. I have paid the price. I have done what I've done, and I've taken the ridicule, and I've kept going. I've taken the blows.
You've made this town.
When I have been a kid, I was picked on as a kid. When I kicked the ass of the punk that pissed me off, then I earned respect. When people got in my face and I popped them in the mouth, they knew what time it was because they knew that I was Gorgeous George and they knew they were in for the beating of their life if they messed with me and an ass thrashing, if you will.
And now okay? I take care of that
and
in Richmond. I take care of that
right.
in Richmond.
You know
now.
What I'm
if
saying?
If you see Gorgeous George, if you see him at Holiday Inn, if you see him on Gray Street, if you see him on Broad Street,
you know what?
I'm always there.
And these people, I tell you what, I'm driving on Gray Street. I'm seeing these drag queens all around me. These freaking drag queens that perambulate the, you know, it's, look, get a job, get off the street, and stop showing your disgusting body on the screen because I know that I don't want to see it, and I'm sure other people don't want to see your homosexual body, okay? I'm not holding any punches tonight. I'm letting it out. Then we had Dirt Woman on. Oh, God, Georgia.
A Richmond monument.
A Richmond mm-hmm. institution, if you will. I've been in an institution. And you know, hell, probably been in several institutions. Oh, but we know we can't, we can't believe you put him on your screen. I put him on the screen to cause controversy, okay? And you people out there that don't get it will never get it, you know?
This is where you see things that you will not see on regular TV.
What's the meaning of your show, Gorgeous George? I am sick and tired of trying to explain the meaning of my
show.
Tell
him, George. Tell him, George.
The meaning of my show is to piss you rednecks and feminist bitches off. To piss you off is my purpose, okay? You can kiss my ass, okay? I am Gorgeous George. I serve a purpose, okay? I trust people. That's my problem. I trust people, okay? People that, you know, get out of the situation, they're part of their ways for me. You see, I'm too
by
nice.
By your choice.
Okay?
By your choice, they part their ways.
Okay? I'm too nice. Okay? And we gotta cut the dead weight, we gotta cut the dead weight. That's all it boils down to. And I am tired and sick and tired of being chastised because, you know what? What's the meaning of your show? The meaning of my show is to piss your rednecks, to piss your feminist people off, okay? That's my goal and what I do. I present a show, a comedy show, and no holds barred. Okay, that's what it boils down to. And, you know, also being talked about. Oh, you did a show in the cemetery.
Oh, my God. George.
Oh, my God.
Phone calls at my house. I got letters. These people had no sense of humor. You got a remote, you got a dial on a TV. If you don't like watching the cemetery, turn the channel. I know why some of you watch.
You see, that's just it.
You keep
it glued on the TV. You complain, all that guy is just totally out there crooking my kids out there. You know, the bottom line is, like I said before, I'm not going to say it again. Don't watch me. You don't like what I do, don't watch me. But the amount of ridicule that I got for doing the show at the cemetery. All what you're doing is blaspheming. You're paying no respect. I got permission, okay? We did it.
One of the best shows that we did,
okay?
And people wrote in, they called in, they stopped me in the mall, they told me the show you did at the cemetery, George, was phenomenal. Okay. It was phenomenal.
I've got mixed reactions on that one show. But like I said once again, okay, it was not making fun of the dead, and it was not making fun of the circumstances around there. It was a show that I did, and that we did.
You own this dump of a town.
And I'm sick and tired of hearing, Weight Watchers. Weight Watchers, huh? I'll show you what we're talking about.
Show them, George. Come on, George.
You think I give a hot, red-hairy ass about Weight Watchers? We are talking about this real deal, the real deal here. I am the real deal. And if you won't, rednecks have a problem with me. I'm not hard to talk. Let me tell you something here.
That's right,
let me tell you something here. Doesn't take forever to figure out what the deal is.
Woo! Woo! That's right!
Ah, I am Gorgeous George!
And I'm here.
And if you like it or don't like it, kiss my ass!
I'm
performing a show for this on Continental Cable TV.
Woo!
And I'm glad you don't
kiss my ass!
It's a service! You see that?
Chisel to show.
Chisel as hell! And your rednecks don't like it? The hell with you! The hell with you! I'm not hard to find!
No!
Anger and hostility has been brought out! I do a show! Wake up, Richmond! I do a show on Continental Cable!
We'll take Wake up. Any two in Richmond!
I do
any
a show on Continental Cable TV! And I do it because it's my baby and it's my brainchild! Okay? You see the deal?
Woo!
You see the picture right here?
Woo!
Okay? As you're seeing
and abortion.
The Italian stallion.
And abortion.
And abortion.
118.
Michelle.
Take $250 down
Michelle,
there.
Michelle.
Do what you have
I
to do.
I see you undressing right now. You say, woo, Gorgeous George! Oh, tell me when you finish! Oh, Gorgeous George, tell me when you're finished.
She can't help herself.
She cannot help herself because she knows the deal. I'm tired of being Mr. Nice Guy. I'm tired of being Mr. Nice Guy and being known as lighthearted, okay? I'm going to piss some more people off, okay? That's my mission, okay? It's now time for seriousness right now, okay? I am for comedy, but it's time now for a little seriousness out there. A little truth serum, if you will.
We've cut the dead weight. Now we're going serious.
Piss the trash off. And that's my mission. Okay? Call me the Antichrist. Call me a vigilante. And you women, you contradiction. I want to say one thing. You women, you contradict yourself, okay? Yes, I had a real crappy birthday, okay? I'm going to be the first one. I had a real crappy birthday, okay? It was piss poor, okay? But that's
most
all right.
People would think that was a good birthday, what you had, George. Yeah. Well, not at your standards, George.
You know, what it boils down to is I've been seeing this girl. I gave this girl an opportunity. She's a dancer. I gave this girl an opportunity to come on with a force right here. She stood me up. I gave this other girl an opportunity to get in the show too. She stood me up. It's
it's not pick a number from the hat, George.
You know, it's time. It's time to pick a number. It's time to wait your turn and pick your number. Okay. I've got anger. I've got some hostility let out, and that's the way it is. I've got a lot of anger, a lot of hostility, but I'm not going to sit. But I'm not going to sit around here and wait around for people to stand me up, because I am going to continue on with the service that I do, and I do create a service. We had a little thing set up here. I'm going to kind of hit around the bush here. A thing set up here with a woman that wanted to get on VGO with me to do a show. Okay? I'm not going to mention your name, but I think you are a psychic. You're a psychic in Richmond.
She could be channeling at the
moment,
George.
You're probably channeling the moment here, okay? You told me that basically you want to get involved and help me on a show on VGO. You stood me up. You know, you're out the door. I'm not holding it back anymore. I'm not letting things just fester. I'm letting it out. Mr. Nice Guy's gone, and the angered side is coming out. Mr. Nice Guy's out the door. In a little bit, I'm going to show you what a little fast love can be all about. Fast love coming up next. Woo! Woo!
Corrupt people like Newt Gingrich. It's going to be new heights and new cloud bounces. I'll trash guys, I'm like that.
Several bad puns later.
We have a few questions sent in from viewers all over the region, as far as Tidewater, up as far as Baltimore. I have a basket at my house. This tall. First of all, they would like to know mainly, what are the plans for the future of the Gorgeous George Show? Where is it headed? Are we looking at any kind of syndication?
It might be headed. It might be headed to the top. And that's the way it's going to go, ladies and gentlemen. I don't have a crystal ball that I can say, hey, well, you know, but I'm getting people calling me up. Young and the Restless. People call me up from the Young and the Restless. We want you to come on.
It's from James Little in Verano, and it says...
I just love them rednecks, but go ahead.
No, can't ever anybody, just anybody do this. You have to be special. Gorgeous George is special.
All I can say is basically that I don't, you know, there's people that we had to get rid of in the past. I'm not going to get into all that. People we had to, you know, get rid of in the past. People not being true to the show. Bands not showing up. To answer your question intelligently, the only group of people I can think of that I can discredit are people that don't like what I do. Discredit the people, the trash out there that downgrade my show.
They know who they are.
And they know who they are, but then you know what? You know what? But do you know what?
What can they kiss?
You know what they can kiss. But you know what? They still watch my show.
They're
no matter if they want to take me
they're
off.
They're compelled to.
If they want to take me off the airwaves, they still watch me. Yes, I'm arrogant. But I've got every way to back it up. I've got every means and every inch of my body can back up what I said. Gorgeous George, ladies, St. Paul, coming into your bed. Okay, we have a discard Fasso. Fasso is talking up the bed. We push him aside. Gorgeous George takes over, ladies.
Boom! As usual.
Takes the Calamano.
Rub that body, all so smooth. Then close the TV. If I've got to break the ocean, if I've got to break...
Park the sea.
If I got to park the sea, if you... VGO is changing their format. And we are changing the format within about 3 weeks. We're going to go into either country or classical.
Oh!
When this show gets aired, probably already will have it. Howard Stern will not Howard Stern will not be on that much longer. I am taking a petition to keep Howard Stern on the radio. I've got a connection. I've got a connection to Howard, and I want to be talking to him pretty soon. And we're going to try to maybe get him in Richmond if possible. It's going to be hard to do that, I know, but I don't care. Okay, I've got...
done hard things before.
Tell you what, Pat Benatar, Richmond native rock and roll singer. We're working on getting her to come on my show. I kid you not. I said Pat Benatar, working on getting her on my show.
Band?
No, I hate Richmond.
Well, love to hate Richmond. Love to hate
Richmond. I hate the conservatism in Richmond. I was born and raised here, but I hate Richmond with a passion. I'm going to make this. People who don't like me, people who discredit me, are the ones that will be laughed at. Okay?
They help us.
People
the most.
Out there that have shut the doors on me at Continental Cable TV, the people who've not wanted my show to air on Continental Cable TV and give me live spots, okay? They're the ones that are going to have the smoke backfire in their face. Like I said, this stripper. Hey, baby, I told you the deal. I told you you can drop that stuff, make more money in hanging in with me. A stripper that works at these bars, I'm not going to mention her name because she's not worthy of that. But hey, I give you an opportunity. When opportunity knocks, you answer the door. You don't blow it off. You answer the door. And I gave you the opportunity of a lifetime, baby. You blew it off. Dirt woman. Oh, George, you know. Did you have a thing going on with Dirt? Mentality level is dead. I did this for controversy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Make the gerbil squeal, won't you? He'll grab that
squirrel and I'll eat the gerbil.
He'll grab the squirrel he'll grab the squirrel by the gerbil by its neck till it pukes.
Yes, yes, yes. They want a Gorgeous George undergarment. Anything that has touched this man.
The phones are going to ring off the hook. You're watching me, okay?
Explosion in my throat. I just landed some corn on the cob and some refried beans and Mark has been feeding me.
Oh. Like here in Helena, Montana, Helena got 6 inches the other day. That is snow. I don't know. The people in Portland, they don't get the crabs there, they get the lobsters. Pittsburgh! You know what people from Pittsburgh are called? Pittsburghers!
But tell us, what kind of showers, though, did come down in San Francisco?
Golden showers. They
are... She feeds me those beans at Taco Bell, and she feeds it to me anally. What is the percentage of showers in these locations, and what's the percentage of nasty stains?
In Dallas, in May.
What's the percentage of golden showers in Detroit?
The part of vandalism on
here meets some gauge. Richmond.
It will never be the same until.
This is the Republican Institute of Life. You want to pass
through my balls. And we'll give you like lip chops, little cow chops, suey, if you know what I'm talking about, for all you little farmers out there.
Ladies and gentlemen, you know, I tell you what, it's been a real, real good feeling, you know, to be on TV for 4 solid years. But let me tell you what I'm doing right now for you all here. If you have marital problems, if you have problems in the bedroom, hey, I'm Gorgeous George. I will pay you a visit, and I will try to take care of your marital problems and give you one-on-one therapy and a one-on-one session.
But are we having a sexual problem here?
We have been, yeah.
Having a sexual problem? Are you satisfied?
We used to have all kinds of good sex.
Yeah. Now, what I want you to do is put your hand on... Right on her side of her hair up there.
You think so?
Yes.
Like that little strangler?
No, just rub her side. No, just rub her side like that. There you go. Uh-huh. What's you do is, you know, you touch parts of the body, you rub parts of the body, and then you take it from the other angle, and you rub the buttocks, and you rub the side, rub the buttocks, and it causes stimulating, and then you carry it off into the bedroom. Ladies and gentlemen, I do make house calls. I make house calls to anybody, and when I have the urge to come and visit you like I just did to this couple, touching causes orgasmic feelings, orgasmic feelings of life. But when you touch and you feel, that starts it off.
Oh man, I tell you, please come. I need some candy. I want candy. Ah, it's you!
It's Grandpa. Well, what I do with my grandchild, I feed him some Werther's.
Doing Columbo? Yeah, I haven't been on TV in like 6 years. You know, I'm the worst jinx ever. Everywhere I show up, a murder occurs.
Are we ready over there?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. I think I see the girl. The girl's coming right up right now.
Yeah, go ahead.
And there she is.
It's you. It's great to see you.
Wow.
Do a dance, your name is Sue.
Susan.
Crack a little bit. Still crack it. Crack it. Is it Baby Spice or what? Who is this?
Yeah.
much. I'll allow us to do that. We've got a new, this is a mess, I know. But hey, I don't care. I mean, I'm paying, they're going to wipe it off, and I'm not worried about it. You know, when you're looking at me, it gives your picture too big and more perception. It gives it more of a high, glossy look. It blesses your picture too. Woo! And it makes you people just want to get down on your hands and knees, baby, and worship the Mac. The Mac of the daddy, the Mac, and that's what it boils down to. I've got a little extra leakage, and kind of leaking just a little bit in the verbal part that we can't really mention. Boom! I've got my little tool right here that I use. Tell us what got you into the exotic dancing system.
Money. I had a few girlfriends that were dancers, and I seen all that money they were bringing home, and I thought to myself, I can do that.
You do that?
Yeah.
That's what it goes down to. Gorgeous George, www.gorgeousgeorge.com, baby. .com. Hello.
This is my lovely wife, Susan.
Hello.
And thanks, that's why I took that for in Maryland, but granted me this privilege to say that because he passed up something he didn't know where he
had. I am the Mac of the daddy of the Mac. I am the sealant and stops the liquid from coming. That's what
he can make rubber cement with his own nose.
Yeah. His infection was created by somebody that had a bad case of gas. But
let's give everybody the dating game.
Yeah. He's not his soul.
And where did this thing happen?
It's like da da da. We have extra
leaking.
You gotta wear your pants because there's so much fluid coming out because of the excitement of seeing this beautiful person on your TVs.
Went to church day, and it felt really, really exhilarating. They were shocked to see me. They were throwing stones at me. Who cast his first stone? We got a little zoom coming on here. And so, it's spinning around like that, and you can see me coming out here. I'm getting a little dizzy. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll be popping through your underwear. I'll be making you, if you girls are naughty or nice, I'll be taking my tongue going like this. To all a nice nutty night, and may all your wet dreams come true. Woo! Woo! Two-minute imprieve, or
the next coming.
Got to find the wall, then lean in and battle a bunch of other gloves. And took it right out of the lefty's glove. Watch this. Watch him take this right out of his glove.
A privilege to be on your screen. This is the box. This is the tube box. I want to hold off on the calls here because I want to talk about some things real fast, and then we'll take the calls in between talking. When you work and date, sometimes it's not congenial or doesn't work. Also kind of curious to know about the Sprewell, Latrell Sprewell. The guy is a low-class half-breed. We're working, we're burning the midnight oil, so to speak. Nature Boy Ric Flair retired 3 weeks ago from wrestling. This happened 3 weeks ago. Being an idol. Being my idol, being the person that, hey, I even look up to someone. One of the best presidents we've ever had. This man has the IQ of a hippopotamus, and I won't be surprised to see the man take a bullet in the head. The man will get a bullet in the head. I see that happening.
Whoa, that's tough talk, but.
Needs to be silent. This man needs to shut up. This man is nothing more he's doing. It's a witch hunt, and it's got to stop. It's very hard to be in a work environment without, of course, this sexual harassment. Oh my God. When you date someone on the workforce, you got to kind of realize that if it kind of ends in a sour note, then
somebody
I'm not trying to come from the male perspective here, but you have to realize I am a male, and I'm talking from the male's perspective. The women, then when it becomes sour, then the woman yells, oh my God, he's doing this to me, he's doing that to me. And then it's hard to date someone that you work with. You know, when it ends sour, then the woman yells,
rape or yells harassment. And the woman usually wins in court because, oh my God, it's rape. Oh, yeah. Oh my God, it's she yelled rape. It's harassment. I mean, this is ludicrous. And we live in a sue happy country. Everybody wants to sue for this and sue for that, and that brings up a valid point. This is Media One Community Access Channel, where you two could talk to the people over here and have your own show anytime you want. But you have to go through, I guess, the guidelines. Or, you know, they don't want to grant me an ongoing live spot. Once in a while, they'll grant it to me, an ongoing live spot. And that's the way it is. Take your calls, but if we feel the demeanor of your call is not appropriate, we're going to cut you off. That's the way it is.
The way of the world.
We're not going to take, you know, if you don't like me, hey, great, God bless you. But if you have a demeanor tonight with me, we're going to cut you right off. That's the way it is. All righty. We have, was it line one or line two?
Doesn't matter.
Well, all right. First line. Line one.
Yeah. I have a question.
All right. First of all, speak up a little bit because I can barely hear you.
I have a question.
Okay. Go ahead with your question.
Can you suck my dick, bitch?
Yeah.
Well, see, your problem is you have a fascination with that and a fixation with it because yours is that small and you have a problem with it, so go take it somewhere else. All right, we have a call. Go ahead.
Hello.
Hello.
Howdy.
Yeah, George.
Hey.
You shop at TJ Maxx, don't you?
TJ Maxx, I don't shop there. Where's this going to?
No, it's okay. Just wondering. Thanks.
Yeah.
Next call. Line two.
Yeah, you mentioned you didn't like the last episode of Seinfeld. I thought it was a good ending. I thought that they, you know, it was great to see all the old characters back and everything like that.
Okay.
I thought it was a pretty good ending myself.
I didn't
but
think
that, so. Most people didn't. And
I didn't think so. Yeah. Well, why being incarcerated? Why end that way? Being incarcerated in jail, I mean, that doesn't make any sense to me.
You know, I mean, there's a lot of topics that they've covered that you might ask why to, but I just thought it was a good idea.
Well,
to,
yeah, I mean, they showed about the bubble boy and the other stuff, about the other skits, which was good to probably maybe go back in time, like a time capsule, but yeah. why come to a dramatic ending like that?
That's what one more thing, Baba Booey.
Baba Booey to you too. Thank you very much. Howard Stern, baby, lives through me in this town. Lion 2, talk to us.
Howdy.
You don't get no pussy, bitch. Fuck you.
Oh,
okay, once again, we have a problem that people do not understand what we're saying to you. You have a problem with your penis. Take it somewhere else. Don't we don't want to hear about it. Take your problem with your penis somewhere else, maybe to Dr. Kevorkian. Okay? Thank you very much. Other stuff you see on this channel is a bunch of mundane stuff that doesn't amount to birds and the bees or a man barfing on the sidewalk. Working upon the Miss Gorgeous George beauty pageant. We did one 2 years ago at Embassy Suites, the U of R girls.
Yeah.
They were the rejects. Now we're working upon the girls from Paper Moon and working upon the girls from Red Light. Hey, jump on excitement, baby. Jump on electricity. Intensity. Shaquille O'Neal is just a wannabe that needs to eat more Taco Bell to make a three throw. Line two, please, or whatever line we're on here. Talk to me.
How y'all doing?
What's going on?
Hey.
Man, y'all are wack as shit, man.
You need to take your language in the commode and barf it out because we're not going to have that tonight, okay? I'm as wacky as what? No, see, you're sitting there. Nothing else better to do with your time than probably satisfy yourself. You know what I'm talking about? And then watch me on your TV screen. Baby, you need to kind of put it in focus. You got a remote control. You can watch the reruns of Jeopardy or Wheel of Fortune at this time or whatever you want to watch or play with yourself. But don't come to me because you're watching me.
You watch Barney.
You can play with Barney. You can have a love fest with Barney. We just did a taping 2 weeks ago. The most beautiful thing we had. The Temptress, we got to give up to her because she's helped us out. Dancer from Red Light, Susan.
Bah, 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 boo.
Susan, and we have her coming up here and two other shows coming up here. We did a charity event at the bowling alley. Excuse me. Hello, that's what that's like, Cuckerman drinking.
What's the purpose of y'all white show? Well, y'all show white, man.
Our show is white? Well, maybe we are white. That's probably
why
it is.
I said y'all show white. I can't. Y'all are white, man.
We're a riot. Well, thank you.
Riot.
White, man.
Well, thank you.
Okay, whatever you're saying, you need to get your tongue moving in the same direction.
Yeah,
Yeah, well, man, you know, it's just the way it is, man. You bees watching me, and I bees watching you, and that's the way it's bees.
Is that right, man? All right, man.
Shut up.
All right, man. Give me five, man. We're cool, blood. We're cool, man.
Gay.
Peace, man.
You're gay. Thanks,
I'm gay? Well, you...
I'm starting to hurt. You starting to hold in my head for real.
I'm gay. Yeah. You know what?
I'm starting to hold in my head, dog.
Okay, first of all, you need to take the thing out of your mouth because we can't understand you. You got something in your mouth that's clogging up your mouth. You got probably cum in your mouth. You need to take it out. Cut him off. Man, I mean, look.
He started off all right.
I mean, you know, whatever. I mean, first, when you call this number, be able to verbalize and be able to talk without having mush or some foreign object in your mouth, okay? Mm-hmm. Jesus.
Marbles or
white stuff in your mouth.
No, Joey. Why did I call you Gorgeous Joey?
You know why?
Why?
Because I call myself that every time I wake out of bed in the morning. And that's all that needs to be said.
Nobody else.
I mean, I woke up one morning and a brick hit me on the head. And I finally realized, well, damn, I'm gorgeous. I realized that I needed to do a show. And it was a calling from God. Oh, my God. Ho. It was a calling from Jesus. And he said, George, you need to go out on TV and show your beautiful face to the public. And Jesus said, whoo, hallelujah, told me to come and do it. So I'm possessed.
If he had to wait for anyone else to call him Gorgeous George, he'd still be waiting.
No, that's okay.
No.
It's conviction and love for yourself.
Hey. When the girls call you Gorgeous George.
The girls call me God.
Yeah, because the girls, I'll be telling they say you're ugly.
Well, you know, gorgeous.
Are you the same guy that's just called us up? I have nothing else better to do with your time than watch.
He's the same guy.
Hey, look, I tell you, why don't you go ahead and hang up? You need to have the implement out of your mouth to come out because you got a fixation with that. Okay, you call this number again. We know who you are. We're going to track you down like a hound dog, and you're not going to be able to prosecute you. Okay. So you got nothing else better to do with your time. Take it somewhere else. Okay, you got a foreign object in your mouth. You got a fixation with an inadequacy about someone's implement. Worry about your daddy's.
And get that finger out of your nose.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
Hi.
Okay. Why not get
yours? Find your show very offensive. It makes my hemorrhoids flare.
Okay.
Well, use some
ducks. You see, you need to see a doctor about that. You need to see a doctor about that, and you definitely need to take it somewhere
else. Talk about all this cursing and everything, and this guy with the curly hair over here, Gorgeous George. Very offensive. His fingers up their nose. Made me fall on the floor and hurt myself.
Why don't you go to the club you're notorious for going to? Why don't you drive to Fielden's and talk to your buddies over there and don't mess with them, okay? Because obviously you're inadequate about your sexuality.
So you want to call up here and talk to me about
listen, take it somewhere else. Take it down and puke it down the commode. Thank you very much.
How about Richmond lesbians?
Lesbians, okay. What about Richmond lesbians? I have no idea. I mean,
what do you think about them here?
What do I think about lesbians? Well, maybe I'm hypocritical. Nice. I mean, you know, your sexual preference is your own sexual thing. It's your own thing all the way through. It's downright out disgusting to visualize two men. And I'm hypocritical, but saying it's downright out disgusting to visualize two men. But it's more acceptable with two women. Blood and male American has thought about having sex with two women. Yes.
Okay. Thanks for calling.
Thank you for your.
I don't want to play with you.
You want to play with me? Well, not me. Why do I suspect? I get the feeling that someone that we know from a past is involved in this. Yeah. And I think
it's all.
I think someone involved in the past is involved in this. And we
Paula
need,
Jones.
No. We need to kind of like say 99.
I remember I've seen you. You know, when you did the show in your house. But what I don't want to know also is when did you pick up that goober beside you?
Nah.
Let me tell you something about this goober. You know what they say? You never judge a book by its covers. This man here is gifted.
Okay,
you can't judge a book by its covers. This man is gifted, is talented, has gonna do any voice
in more than one way, right?
What's that?
That's
okay.
My fans.
Okay, something about your nuts. Whatever. I think, you know, you can crack your nuts. You bash this man, you bash me. This man is a part of what we do. To hell with you. This man has been a very, very much a incentive to the show, and he's helped the show. So to hell with your comment, okay?
Thank you. No. And
I don't think...
And I think that...
Did you like that?
No, I think that Kevin is my
Crafty name. Kevin.
Yeah.
Gorgeous Stewart.
Crafty Kevin.
Crafty Kevin and Gorgeous Stewart.
My name is that.
All right. Okay.
Well, thanks.
Well,
hey,
all right. Okay. And this, hey, whatever. Time is wasted. Go ahead. Line, whatever. Line.
How you doing?
Two, three, four.
One.
Go.
Oh, I was wondering, George, what do you do in your spare or in for a profession?
What I do for a profession? I bartend and I'm a courier.
Where do you guys want to take this show? What is your goal? I mean, are you trying to be the next David Letterman or something?
Well, David Letterman is very much. I mean, rules. I mean, he's funny, and he has his own little show. No, I don't critique myself with anybody. I do what I do. I do this. I've been doing it for 4 years, and people tell me, George, why are you still in Richmond? Well, I'm still in Richmond because I'm still in Richmond. My privy, or if you've seen the show before, have you? Or what?
I have, actually.
You have?
Yeah.
Okay.
You watched it again?
Okay.
Well, I think you guys are entertaining, to tell you the truth, but I'm not laughing with you, I'm more or less laughing at you.
As long as you're laughing.
Like I said, you're entitled to your delusional opinion, and that's fine. You can laugh at us all you want. We find it funny. We have followers out there that find what we do to be funny. And so whatever your trip is, that's fine.
Well, I don't have a trip, but you get on and you're all confident and cocky and arrogant about how all these women want to sleep with you and stuff.
Well, you perceive that. That's your perception. You don't even know me. You don't even know if it's a facade. You don't know what the show is about. You picture to me to be a playboy, which in some cases
I am. No, I really don't. I think you're all talk, probably. I don't think you've probably been laid in quite a while.
Well, you know what I think? I think that you what you can do is pull your pants down and play with your pet gerbil with your Ever-Ready battery cell and take a dump at the same time, because what you have to say to me is as the hill of beans. Okay, take it somewhere else, fat boy. I don't need to hear your crap. Come off. Cut him off. Okay. All right, fatty. All right. Listen to me. You can take your opinion and ram it down the commode and then flush it, because that's the equivalent to the insignificant chatter that I'm hearing on the phone here. You know, this other guy that called me up about 2 months ago, anything and everything sucks, you know? You suck. You are a wannabe. Anything and everything that sucks, you are a wannabe. People know who I am, baby, when I walk into a freaking room. A first country nation. We'll be right back.
I've only seen, this is the first time in months I've seen him. We've been taking a vacation from each other.
Exactly. On later hours now, we're on at 1 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock in the morning, due to people calling up here and making complaints about, we've been through this over and over again, and you really don't see my show on as much as you usually do in the past, or have done in the past. This show itself pretty much is a live call-in show where you, the fans or the haters or whatever you want to call yourselves, can talk to me, and we can talk to you with, you know, with a little bit of respect. Now, once again, the same guidelines stand. If you get vulgar, if you get over excessive, if you talk and you get a little bit out of the range where we don't want to, you know, talk to you anymore, then you will be cut off. I just want to talk about the show itself. Like I said, the show is on now at 2 o'clock in the morning, 1 and 2 o'clock in the morning. They have limited me from being aired during the day due to
people calling up there, voicing their opinion, not on the listings, but I'm not on the listings in the channel guides, but 1 o'clock and 2 o'clock. And a criminal act. Every president in history. She's very shy, very introverted.
In the real scheme,
I have made thousands of plunders and thousands of mistakes. I have made thousands of plunders and thousands of mistakes. I have made thousands of plunders and thousands of mistakes. Popularity backing.
I like
this has been a political lambusco. It is not in a criminal offense. And Samai's the woman, he did not say that he had a sexual relations with Monica Lewinsky. He said he had an inappropriate affair. And catch me on www.com, whether we lose our temper. I've lost my temper on numerous occasions. Even on TV, I've lost my temper. Let's talk about this faggot.
Yes. Oh, wait a minute. He's gone. He's back. Wait a minute. You didn't see it. You didn't tear enough pictures of him.
You faggot, you son of a bitch. You homosexual faggot, you son of a bitch. I'm going to get the last laugh here. And I am the one that's going to be the one smiling at the outcome. You're just a human piece of waste that needs to be done away with. Fuck you. Fuck you and go to hell. Just like I'm gonna make things stick in your jurisdiction when I get into your real world, motherfucker, into your real world, and I get you exposed and I cause a little havoc, if you will, in your world. I am productive, but you fuck with a lion, you parrot a stick of the lion, eventually that lion is going to eat you. And you keep poking that stick at me, I'm going to maul you. You piece of shit. You pile of shit. And Miller, if you're listening out there, put your head in here. Come to my door. Knock on this door right here. I dare you. Knock on this door right here, motherfucker. Miller, you come to my house. I will maim you. I will maim you. I will maul you till you can't get up off the floor. Till you can't get off the freaking floor. Brennan, you faggot. Thank you very much for doing that to me. I appreciate that shit.
What kind?
It's fun again. It's fun again. I'm sorry. Start this again.
But no.
Yeah. But we have done things. We have done things that we have regretted. The guy is nauseous. If I was forced to come out, I would come out. Counterclock what they said. If he gets impeached, I will willingly not do any more shows.
Enigma.
Susan McDoodle. Doodle. Said I had an end. So you right-wing conservatives, or a woman's a lesbian, or you can't fight for the, we can base it upon the fact this and that. You know, I don't care who he sleeps with, as long as it's not me. Okay? I am a heterosexual, baby. Hetero. A collapsing in Japan on the breakfast table, and his head is like on the breakfast table.
Well, that was good.
Hello.
How you doing?
How you doing?
I was just wondering why the guy on the left looks like Urkel and you're a fat ass.
Yeah. Well, thanks.
Okay. Let me tell you something, okay? You see, cut him off, okay?
I think he was looking in the mirror.
Maybe you're looking back at him. Maybe you're looking yourself in the mirror, and if you had anything to say to me, okay, you can go ahead and take your face and dump it down the commode because, buddy, don't get personal with me. You don't even know who I am. Buddy, I could be your worst freaking nightmare. Pump, it's like this last pump scum that called up here and called me a fat ass. Yeah. Excuse me. The pump scum that called up here, you know, wishes he was me.
Good
what's going on? What's going on? What's up?
Yeah. Nice jacket. Nice jacket.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I got it through a person, you know. My name's Lampeezy. In case you haven't got a clue, in case you're channel surfing, you don't know what time it is, once again, it's time for an hour pat of unending syllables coming through my mouth. And for an education for you all to learn and take a notepad in hand and learn and take some notes. There will be a test after the show. No calls, not just yet. I will grant you 3 wishes. What would be your 3 wishes?
Genie.
Yes, we'll talk about
money,
that.
Money, money, more money.
That's what it boils down
to. Five greatest.
Well, women, more women, and panty sniffing, baby. We sniff them panties, and we tell you if it's done. If it ain't done, we won't take them off until it's done, baby. Boo!
Shut up! Shut up!
Because he was the pilot, doesn't he?
Excuse me, I'm talking. And go through the chronology, aquatic. People like dirty laundry, you know, the downhilly tune. People like the dirty laundry, and they like John Fritz stole candy eloquently. But you see, and of course, you hear about Elvis Presley still being alive, working in Cleveland, flipping hamburgers. Oh, honey, two for the money, two for the show. Three, get ready, baby K, baby go.
He's working at pizza on a commercial.
Oh, baby, let's rock. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much. And he DOA'd in his bathroom. Same thing about James Dean. You hear the same thing about Marilyn Monroe. Hello. Watch that camera. Let me say something about Ted Kennedy.
Ted Kennedy's always
like... Eiswalt. Negligent. I'm not a pilot. I'm not anything like that. But I do know that you know, when you're new and driving a plane, you're trying to talk to us. You're
Addy.
You're on the air.
Hey.
What's up?
Hey.
Hey. You're on the air. Talk to us.
Listen, so I see your cleavage. What size cup are you?
Baby, if you want to know and feel, why don't you bring your head a little closer and I'll breastfeed you. Take it off, basically. Okay, come on, I think it's crap. Get off my freaking head.
You know, we do,
let me give you my top 10 right here. I'll give you my top 10. Number 10 is Stevie Nicks. For her age, she's still...
Not Stevie Wonder, man.
Well, we know that you like blind men, okay? Because basically, we know where you take it. We know where you take it, what hole you take it up. Basically.
Talk shows, they always make a big deal about how...
Okay, Matt, happened here? Where you going, man? Where you going?
Where's he going?
He's got to go to the potty. He's going to the potty.
Looks exactly like her.
I think she'll crow. Number 6... Jennifer Aniston.
Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah. Okay. Why don't you go back and get some jelly back there? Get yourself a peanut butter and jelly sandwich back there and fit yourself, bitch. I'm talking to him back there.
Talking to me?
Yeah, I'm talking to Lou.
Black lovers on the phone.
Okay. I got your.
We got your. Number I got right your here.
Lover. I got your lover, and he's a guy, and he's on the phone, and he wants to talk to you, Mr. Matt. Richard Gere. Partake in some gerbil food too, basically. gerbil foods, food supply, basically. Of course, 3 is in between, I guess. I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. I blanked out. But anyway, we gave
RuPaul.
You.
RuPaul. No, that's not what else.
That's Matt's girlfriend. That's Matt's girlfriend. Anyway, listen, Mr. Matt, how's your peanut butter and jelly sandwich back there? Pretty good? Huh? Huh? I think you have something in your mouth and in your stomach.
I don't.
You know that stomach pump? You know what I'm talking about?
I know what he's talking.
He's got some white stuff in his mouth. Some tossed salad in his mouth. He was flying to his Matt, shut up back there. In New York to Martha's Vineyard.
Oh, okay.
To that. Be quiet back there, Matt. Once again, we're still working during the red tape. The Gorgeous George Show will be extended once again.
The Gorgeous George Show. We're like George a bad coin. You can't get rid of us.
Will be extended once again. I will be in Vegas for about 3 weeks in the middle part of August. And this man right here will be the host for 3 to 4 weeks on the block of August.
Get your VCRs looked and looked over the Florida Ocean. And then
I think the guy's on crack, basically. if me or Kevin were in for something, we'd be on the top of the list, too. Because we are the celebrities here in Richmond, Virginia.
Yeah.
Style Weekly, you need to put me in the front cover. You need to put this man in the front cover. Richmond Times-Dispatch, Douglas Durden, what's up? You need to put me in the front cover and do an expose about the man who's causing all this. Line 2, talk to us. You're on the air.
Put the radio on the cover this week.
You're on the air. Talk to us.
Why the plane went down?
Pardon me?
I said I had a theory about why JFK's plane might have went down.
Why?
I think George was bending over to take a shit.
Take him off.
Okay, well, first of all, you have a problem with your sexuality, okay? You need to take care of your hemorrhoid problem. Use Tux, my friend. And then what you also need to do is to take care of your brain. Because there's a lot of hemorrhaging coming out of your brain because obviously someone has slugged you a few times and, you know, you might get slugged again tonight. Line 2, talk to us. You're on the air.
I had the 3 things you were talking about, like a 3 wish thing.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Go ahead.
I just wanted to make one quick Kent Kennedy comment.
Right on.
You know that their house is built on an Indian burial ground, don't you?
I didn't know that.
No, the one that they haven't even moved into?
Excuse me?
There's one that they're building, I heard, that hasn't been, that they're hardly finished. It's going to be,
I don't know. I just had heard a long time ago that the house had been, you know, the Kennedy Mansion.
In Hyannisport?
Yeah.
Massachusetts, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway, well.
Didn't know that. How did you know that?
I heard it a long time ago. I can't remember where I heard it from.
On the internet.
Huh?
On the internet? Did you?
No, way before, you know, people were net surfing.
All right.
The three list thing.
All right.
Marilyn Monroe.
Oh, yeah.
You to bathe and then to get a brain.
Who? Oh, funny man. Funny man.
What did you say?
He didn't say anything, actually.
Judith Eve.
He said that he'd like to have a date with Marilyn Monroe. Dig her up, pal.
Well, I mean, about getting a brain.
No, he did. On to the next story.
Well, no, I'm kind of curious. I mean, did you catch that?
I heard. Yeah, I got it.
What did he say?
He said nothing worth repeating. Okay. I think I you know, it's too bad for a guy who, what he lacks in intelligence, he makes up for in stupidity.
Let me tell you about brains, because obviously when brains were created in the heavens, you went ahead and said it and thought it was a train, and you caught the A train, baby, and the A train was to get an education. So shut up, play with yourself a little bit, and learn from the man who's causing all this. Learn from every syllable that comes out of my mouth and get an education. And you'll know, because the test will be out pretty soon, and you'll flunk the test.
Right on.
Okay? Don't talk to me this crap. All right, I want to hold off on the calls because...
Yeah, we're getting the paper hat crowd right now.
Let's...
hey, we don't go to McDonald's to bother you when you're working, so don't bother us now. Unless you have something intelligent to say.
Mr. Matt, are you screening these calls back there, or do we have
to... I think Marley Matlin would do a better job screening the calls.
Are you screening the calls, or are you just playing with yourself back there? What's up? What's up?
Caller ID is busted.
Okay.
All right.
What else is line one talk? Yeah. Is you on the air?
You're a fat fuck.
Excuse me?
You're a fat fuck.
All right, okay. Yeah, we heard that.
I see the hand gestures, but I'm not...
You see,
I'm going to hold off. I'm going to hold off for a second here. Oh, okay. Okay, that's great. Well, now I can fix my pretty hair. And to that caller that just called up here, why don't you just get yourself a personality? Why don't you take your head and bob for your waist matter? Okay?
You can't buy personality.
Bob for your waist matter and then eat it and die of salmonella poison, basically, because you need to. You need to be buried alive, punk. Yeah. All right, don't call this number again, okay? I don't care, whatever. Use some discretion back there. Use some way of tracking these calls down, okay? Use your own intuition back there, okay?
Yeah.
Bottom line. All right, any calls back there?
Remember, no matter how much money you have, pal, you cannot buy personality.
Okay. And the guy obviously has nothing else better to do than use vulgar tones on my show.
Yeah.
You need to bob your waist matter and swallow your waist matter.
We can be vulgar all the while we want, but
we're talking about some topics once again. So people need to get a respect. People need to respect what we're talking about. Yeah. People need to respect the form of the show tonight. Bottom line. I want Mr. Paul Katagi to be answering the phones. I don't want Matt back there answering the phones. Paul, I want you to man the phones back there.
You've been fired.
I want to talk to us.
Addie.
You're on the air.
Go, man.
Hello?
Hello. You're on the air.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that dude that was talking about the Chesapeake plane crash, that was kind of messed up that you said he was on crack, because that was a legit.
Okay, come off.
What are these people?
Come off. Line two, talk.
Everywhere we go, we're surrounded by schmucks.
Line two, talk. You're on the air.
Is it just us? Why do we attract such people?
Well, you know, they have nothing else better to do than sit here and watch. We have been extended, baby. We have been extended until the last week of September, so you're going to have to learn to love me.
Where?
Whether you like me or don't like me, baby, I'm on for another 8 more weeks. 8 more weeks of the show. He's doing 3 weeks by himself. Hey, this is what's causing all this, baby. It's the show. It is the franchise. It is what's causing all this. We want to give him a test run to host the show for 3 weeks. I know you're going to do me proud. I know you're going to do me proud.
I'm so nervous.
Okay.
And KLZR's Cavalcade of Fun is on this week. How you doing?
Oh, hi, I'm good. I just want to say that I'm a relatively new viewer, but I can already tell you're all fucking...
All right. How you doing? Good to see you, pal. KLZR's Cavalcade of Fun.
Oh, Hello?
How you doing?
Hey, what's that six pack?
Yep. But I'll rise to the occasion.
To our older age, because they're trying to rid cancer. I think by the year 2000 and some 2010 or 2020, mm-hmm. hopefully they'll be able to rid cancer. They're working upon that, ridding AIDS, the disease like that. So I think it'll be more of a longer lifespan for most people. Got a question back here for you guys. Who is manning the phones back there right now?
I think I.
Okay. All right. No disrespect, Mr. Matt. I want Paul to man the phones, please. Okay?
And he's screening.
Okay, that's fine. That's fine. A lot of chronology within the family.
Hello?
Hello. You're on the air.
Hello?
One more time. You are on the air. Talk to me.
Talk to him.
Yes, I want to talk about the three girls.
Okay.
Right on.
Okay.
yeah, all right.
Huh?
I want Jennifer Lopez.
Yeah,
okay.
I want.
We get... Pamela Anderson.
Okay.
Jenny McCarthy.
Yeah. Jenny McCarthy. I forgot about her. Jenny McCarthy. Jenny McCarthy.
I like my top three women are Ginger, Marianne, and a little bit of Mrs. Howell thrown in.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your call.
What makes y'all so intelligent than anybody else? Why do y'all think y'all are the shit?
Hey,
well, first of all, you need to clean up your language,
yeah,
and you need to get off my air with that language.
It's a reflection of your
Thank
mother
you
not raising you right.
Exactly. You need to get off your air with that language.
With that
okay.
gutter
Thank
talk.
You very much. Yeah, I know what I talk about. I know what I say is the gospel truth. So, you know, if you don't like it, then don't watch it. You know, we carry a conversation, basically. If you don't like the conversation, then don't watch me, because what I say is 95%, if not 99.1% true.
Yeah.
Like Howard Stern, you tell the truth, you hear what you want to hear. But if the truth stands out, you don't want to hear the truth, and I tell the truth, basically. No more calls. What's that?
A woman.
All right.
Here comes a woman.
Let's do it. Talk to us. Make it clean. You're on the air. Last call. Talk to us. Hello?
Yes. I'd like to comment on the three sexiest men.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That's number three, it would be... Let's see. It would be Matt Damon.
Oh, Matt Damon. Okay.
Not Magic. You sure it's not Magic Matt? Magic Matt? Okay, go ahead.
Who else?
And number two would be Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Okay. All right.
And number one is Gorgeous George.
Yeah, there he is.
Good for you.
Thank you very much for your call. I appreciate it.
Thank you, ma'am.
And thank you very much. Tell Style Weekly, too, that they need to do an expose of me. Thank you very much. Yeah. No more calls. Let's end it on a good note. No more calls.
Yeah,
let's end on a good note. We got 1 minute left here. When we have this to be said about the beautiful wonder, the Gorgeous George wonder popping through your panties, let's let it be known that I am what's causing all this in Richmond, Virginia.
He the man.
Our national anthem.
Yeah, my favorite part of this whole Gorgeous George stuff is the fact that he did a recent video of myself, and he found out what my real name is through the DMCA claims. And my favorite part of the whole thing is that every time he does videos, it seems like something to look forward to when you watch him. Like, as far as the rants. I'm not talking about the show. Also, I love the fact when he found a random picture of some dude that had a hairy beard that looked like a Saddam Hussein looking fella and claimed that was me. And I love the fact that he made up stories and said that I stalked women, that I set fires at Goodwill one night. There is no record of any of that shit whatsoever.
Captain Corpulence here, and the reason I find Gorgeous George so amusing is that he has a miniature personal black cloud of bad luck that hovers over his head, dishing him out doses of bitch slaps that bring him back down to reality constantly. And this is compounded by the fact that he is pretty much always defeated by the remorselessness of his own stupidity. He portrays himself as this mover and shaker of Richmond, and that he gets all these girls and drives these fancy nice cars and thinks that everyone believes his bullshit, and the reality is everyone sees right through it. This is a case of the Emperor having no clothes, and in this case the Emperor is a pauper, and he thinks we don't know that he rubs dongs, but guess what? We do.
The reason why Gorgeous George has provided me and many others plenty of lols is the simple fact because of how stubborn and pig-headed he is. I mean, George, all this would stop simply if you would just ignore it. But that's the beauty of it. This whole act or that you're trying to put on, that you're some A-list celebrity and being on public access for 20 plus years like it means anything, that's what's funny about it. That's the only thing that's funny about you, is because you think you want us to take you serious. Well, I mean, the only thing that's redeeming about you is acting like a blithering idiot, just being insane, filing lawsuits over and over again. What is this, 5-6 years now? Doing the same thing, 7 years? And it's not getting anywhere. The court system doesn't take you serious because you're full of shit. Judge Spencer, Judge Locke, and then there was another judge. There was three different judges that have never taken you serious because you, one, you write on a slant, and two, you have no grounds to make any sort of complaint. Speaking of, you steal like third-party material for your shows all the time using music without any of the artist's permission, and then you bitch and yell when anyone critiques you or your work. Hypocrisy much? George, continue doing this though, because you'll continue providing lols for the masses.
The most funny experience I remember from the Gorgeous George trolling days is definitely when we got his first account taken down. I think it was called GG on DVD. We had gotten him 3 copyright strikes, and that was going to be his big money maker, where he was, you know, going to sell his DVDs of his highly entertaining show, which never happened, by the way. And yeah, we got that channel taken down. He raged so hard. I made the stir-fried vodka piss matter video that really rubbed it in that he lost his YouTube channel, and that made him butthurt and rage for weeks, I think even months, I can't remember. But yeah, we've always controlled George, we've always made him butthurt. We will continue to make him butthurt, especially Sean. He makes Gigi the most butthurt recently, I would say. But yeah, George, we will always control you, and we will always make you dance. Dance! Put on your sad face and dance the blues. Like a puppet, George, dance for us. You will dance. You will dance. You will dance!
Gorgeous George, you suck fucking ass.
George Alexander Yad, a.k.a. Gay. He can't talk properly. He stinks like shit. Writes on a slant and makes a mockery of the judicial system. George stole his mom's house and committed multiple acts of bestiality, fingering his dog Fontaine. The only women Gigi can get are nasty ratchet that he's drugged to come on his show. He's a laughing stock on the internet and real life. George, keep filing lawsuits, raging and failing. And remember, we control you.
The only thing bigger than GG's constant failures is his fat gut. George is the epitome of being a dumbass. His constant, worthless lawsuits, his addiction to taking tranny loads at Fieldins, stuffing his fat face at Nacho Mama's, and being a raging butthurt bitch. George, if I had a penny for every time you failed, I'd have a six income figure. And in the words of Gretchen on line one, fuck you, George. And Donald Trump is polling really well with uneducated whites, and apparently he must be polling very well with overweight whites. So fuck you, George. Go collect your Social Security check and vote Trump.
Hey, George. How's it going? This is Chipmunk Fuck from the DNR show. I want you to know one thing and one thing only. Your show will always suck. And thank you for the 150 new listeners and followers to the DNR show. Oh, how come you had a sexual predator living with you for 10 years and why'd you steal your house from your mom? That's what I want to know. That's what I really want to know. Plus, how's it feel knowing she's getting rail fly from some meth head for like $5 and chicken nuggets, you fat pig?
What else is GG good for besides laughing? His whole life is dedicated to failure. SA owns him, the goons own him, Master Donk's students own him, Sue owned his ring until she hawked it for meth. Go rub dongs at Fieldins and stay off the internet.
And before I go, one last thing. Fuck you, George! Ah! Fuck you!